Archbishop Vincent Nichols, President of the Bishops' Conference of England and Wales. We have a historic occasion, an Argentinian Pope, first Jesuit Pope, first non-European Pope for 1,000 years. What a night last night.
Well, it was indeed, and I, like everybody else, when I heard his name, I thought, now who's that? And very quickly, we've all been chasing to get the information that we can. But it is a remarkable and very exciting moment. I think it's wonderful that the old church can come up with such a surprise and absolutely hold the world's attention. And in that sense, put somebody there who is really going to, I think, bring something fresh to the papacy.
And did we perhaps see that Jesuit spirituality with the rather humble and prayerful initial address to St. Peter's Square in the world?
I'm sure that's the fruit of Jesuit spirituality and of a deep spiritual life. But it is wonderful that after, what is it, over 400 years of the Society of Jesus, there is now a Jesuit Holy Father, there's a Pope who has been formed in that school. And it's also fascinating that he's from an Italian family. He's from a working class background. He's grown up in Latin America. He studied in Germany, so he understands European academic life. He's a scientist, a trained scientist, who brings together the worlds of science and faith. So he's a man who's got immense riches in his life experience, which will now be brought to the service of the church as the universal pastor, as the priest for the world, as the Holy Father.
And with those wonderful gifts, we do also see a man of the people, don't we? I've seen on Twitter postings of him on the tube in Buenos Aires, and we hear about his deep commitment to poverty and social issues.
I think that's right. And obviously there is, here in this country certainly, and around the world, great interest in Catholic social teaching. And what we have now is a Holy Father who I think will give a sharp edge to that out of his experience of being alongside people who are poor and for whom poverty, to some extent anyway, is increased because of some of the economic structures and the activities that go on in a globalized world. So I think he will bring an extra dimension to the ongoing development of Catholic social teaching, and that will be very exciting too.
And finally, Archbishop Nichols, what would you say to Catholics in England and Wales that are obviously waking up quite joyous at this news?
And rightly so. The relationship between the faithful, me, all of us, and the Holy Father is one of the heart. He resides in our heart. He's our Father. We've not been just given a new chief executive. It's a Father in God, a Father of a family. And that's a moment of great joy. For me personally, I don't think I'd ever felt as keenly the absence of a Pope. And now we have a Father, Habemus Papam, and we should be very, very joyful this morning indeed.